With this workflow, you can create entire marketing plans for yourself or for your clients that include all of the major marketing methods, ranging from social media, paid ads, prints, emails, and more, just by filling in a few details and letting the power of advanced AI reasoning create you the perfect plan. And as always, you can download this n8n workflow for free from my free school community, where we give away over 25 different business-focused workflows for free, with new free workflows coming out every week, along with tutorial videos, how-to setup guides, and a community of automation-focused business owners all looking to collaborate and grow their businesses with AI-powered automations. You can also join our advanced community for tech support assistance, marketing and business growth discussions, as well as getting to pick my brain on n8n, AI automation, or businesses in general. So let's go ahead and take a look at how the workflow actually works. And before we do that, let's see what it actually put out. So we'll come over here, marketing plan output, and we'll see we've got this whole thing here, and it's all of this here. So we come in here, we've got, you know, just it scrolls and scrolls. We got performance. What do we got? We got paid social advertising strategy. What was this one? This was the full marketing plan. This is the marketing plan outline. We've got the paid social media, a paid online search. We chose not to do digital advertising. I'll show you here. We chose not to do digital advertising, so it didn't fill that one in for us. Organic social plan. And I didn't fill it in because I decided not to. I was able to toggle a switch. I'll show you right here. Over here in this spreadsheet, I can choose which ones I want to include or not. So I could have included it. I just decided not to for the sake of being able to show you that it worked. It comes up with an organic social plan, print advertising, email marketing, could have done mail as in snail mail, but again, I had that turned off right there just to show you, and influencer strategies. It creates all of it, and it does it all probably within about 5 minutes. It's really cool being able to watch this just fly through and develop these incredible marketing strategies. So let's just take a look at influencer marketing really quick. So our campaign goals and objectives to drive, you know, 100 plus trial signups, achieve 5-to-1 ROI. That's healthy. Okay. Generate 200,000 plus impressions. That's good. And secure 15 plus pieces of UGC. And so then those are the goals it sets. And then it comes up with the exact strategy. So we need to have audience alignment. It thinks legal tech would be a good idea for us. Interesting. E-commerce, fintech startups, indie game developers. That's an interesting one. I hadn't considered that for my softwares. Engagement rate, it thinks we need about 3.5 or higher on our primary platforms. Proven content quality in order to prioritize influencers. We need to be able, oh, these are for the influencers. I see. So this is how we're selecting them. That makes a lot of sense. Okay, so they need to have good engagement. They need to have good quality. Their platforms, Instagram, TikTok, YouTube, and LinkedIn. And then what does it think we need to focus on? Micro-influencers and nano-influencers. Interesting. Probably because the budget. It thinks it'll cost less if we have these smaller people. Plus affiliate commission. And the nano-influencers give the free access. I usually try to pay everybody myself. So it thinks we should get 4 micro-influencers, 5 nano-influencers, have a budget of $500. And I did set my budget over here in my marketing plan. And so over here, I set $5,000 as a total budget. And it broke up my budget over here in the outline. Double check on the outline, yeah. And so for my influencer strategy, it gave me $600 total. I like that. All right. And so it really thought it through. It broke up my budget. It developed each of these strategies based on the budget, based on what we have available to us. Really cool. All right. So how does this actually work? Well, we start with a spreadsheet. We have our marketing plan input. So you don't have to start with a trigger. I just have it set as a trigger because me personally, I'm not going to turn this on. Maybe you have some sort of schedule trigger or however you want to do it. I just click the button down here to make it run. But it's going to pull from my marketing plan input here. So when I have my information put in here, and the sections in the dark green are what you need to fill in. All right. So you need your product name and service, and the product name and service should match what's in your customer avatars, your create your product services, all the other sections of the whole marketing plan generator system so that it lines up right. In kind of one nice straight shot. The benefits will get created in the part 1 of the marketing plan generator system. That's the benefits creator bot. That video should already be out. I'll have the link in the description below for you. But that creates our benefit statements. We get taglines and benefit statements of why a customer would want this. We choose what type of marketing that we want to do here. So I had paid social, paid online search. I didn't do additional digital advertising, but organic, print, emails, and influencer strategy. So those are the ones I chose, and that's what it output. All right. And then what it does is if that section was marked complete, so here we see an if node. If it says complete here over in this bright blue section, or done, I should say, it's going to skip it. So this allows you to have additional products. It allows you to have additional businesses that you might be running. And it'll run through each in turn to be able to generate your marketing plan for each. All right. If this was empty, it would include it in the run. All right. So then next it'll come through and it'll pull more information. It's going to pull our information from our describe your business sheet. That's all in, again, the marketing plan generator master spreadsheet. So over here, we've got this information in green that you need to fill out. Again, if you have done step one, which is the benefits creator, you've already filled this in. If you've done step two, which is our customer avatar generator, I'm going to mention in just a second, that should all be filled in. But if you haven't, you just fill in the dark green sections, your company name. If your company has a face, the person presenting this material, you'd mark yes and then put the name. So that's me. Otherwise, just mark no. Do you have a tagline or motto? The industry that you're in, the types of products or services that you offer. The benefits creator will fill in the top five, your five benefits for yourself, for your company, for your products. Your customer avatar generator will fill in the customer ID, your ideal customer avatars for your business, and fill all that in for you. And then what it does is it will take all of that information. It's going to generate a comprehensive outline using our DeepSeek reasoning model. So just set up your DeepSeek credentials if you don't have that yet. I'll put a video in the description below on how to set up DeepSeek, get the API for that. But we're using a reasoning model. We want it to really think through all of the details and generate a comprehensive marketing plan outline. We're not filling in each individual item yet. It's just coming up with the big picture. And then we're going to take that big picture, put it back into the spreadsheet. So that's what this node here does. It's going to put it back into our marketing plan output, into over here, into our this column here, our marketing plan outline. It's going to put that all in there. It then, that's the only thing it puts in. Again, connect your Google Sheets account. If you don't have Google Cloud Console, I'll have a video in the description below for you. And then it takes all of that information and it's going to separate it into each of the types of marketing that you wanted included in your plan. So if you only wanted to talk about paid social, or you only want to do an influencer strategy, you would just come over to this, the marketing plan input, and then you would just toggle it, yes or no. Easy enough. So you could just set all of them to no if you wanted, and then only have, say, the influencer campaigns. You could do that, just like that. And it only output the one type of campaign that you're looking for. All right, but each of the types of campaigns that you have chosen, it's going to send that information down the path. And each of these is more or less the same prompt. It's just this one is for paid social, this one's for paid or paid online search, digital, organic, and so on. And we see that it gets all the information from the previous nodes. We get our promotion name, so our product service name, and the it's from the previous node. And that's just from the spreadsheet. And we get our marketing plan outline, as well as all of the information that was in the spreadsheets. So just all of that information that we had. And we run it through the system prompt here. And there are, it's a world-class digital marketing strategist specializing in, and then here is where it's different from the rest. So this one's paid social. And again, the other next one will say paid online search and then digital and organic social and all that. And so its task is to provide, take the provided marketing plan outline and develop the full paid social advertising section. So this was the part that got changed here in the asterisk section. All right, ensures that it's strategically optimized and that it considers how other marketing efforts may affect or enhance it as well. And so it takes the context, it defines the social platform strategy. In this case, this section is different, and I'll show you here how it's different from the others in just a moment. but it recommends the most effective platforms, and it recommends the targeting. It comes up with a creative and ad format strategy that you should use. So whether carousels would be better than stories or reels or collection ads. It provides the content strategy. So what should the content look like? What should it say? What should it focus on and talk about? What are your call to actions? It talks about brand consistency, making sure that everything looks right according to what your brand should be. It takes your funnel strategy into consideration and your customer journey. So it should consider whether the social media should be the top of funnel or the middle of funnel or the bottom of funnel, or what each of those should look like for that social media. It talks about where the budget should be allocated and how you should consider spending it and bidding. It talks about the data analytics and how you optimize your KPIs, as well as adapting to other external factors. And it just has some other things that it shouldn't do. Like, don't discuss other sections of the marketing plan. The social media section shouldn't talk about the snail mail section, right? Don't include generic recommendations. Don't ignore cross-channel impacts. Don't assume this one size fits all strategy. It needs to be super narrowly tailored to this business, to these customer avatars, to your benefits and your products. All right. I've spent a lot of time really crafting this system prompt to be able to generate stuff that's really good for my clients. And so I'm giving it to you. All right. And then here we have, again, an output, a sample output for it to use. That way it has some idea of what it should do. And we'll come over here and take a look at kind of what it did. So we got paid social. Our primary platforms are LinkedIn. Justification for LinkedIn, because 63% of LinkedIn users engage with SaaS content. There's Instagram and Facebook. And it says, why not TikTok or X? It says limited ROI for time-strapped professionals. And TikTok's Gen Z skew is misaligned with our primary customer avatars. I like that. It really did take into consideration our customer avatar information. All right, so our audience segmentation, our core demographics, who we're targeting, their behavioral information to target, what kind of custom audiences we can make. So here, retarget website visitors who viewed pricing or feature pages using a 7-day window. The fact that it says a 7-day window, it means it really thought it through. Upload an email list if we have one for cold and warm leads for a lookalike audience. Exclude certain people because it avoids non-decision makers. I like that. Test job clusters and ad formats for A/B testing. Here's the type of content for LinkedIn. It says we should make 15 to 30 second video ads of me demoing the products, carousel ads for Instagram and Facebook using story ads with quick cut testimonials, okay, and collection ads showing how it works. And then, you know, creative guidelines. And it does that again for all of these: brand consistency, funnel and customer journey. So here's the awareness stage, the consideration stage, the conversion stage. Here's some cross-channel synergies it can do using influencers. We can repurpose micro-influencer testimonials in order to be able to get them as part of our content. Email as well. You watched our demo. Here's your trial link. Oh, great. All right, it's got our budget. It breaks down the budget between the different types of social media platforms where we should spend that money each month. Performance metrics and optimization, what kind of KPIs should we be looking for in order to see whether this is a good campaign. Optimization tactics, when should we optimize and update, refresh creatives weekly, daily, adjust our bidding for high intent times. All right. And not that you need to necessarily do that anymore. A lot of the algorithms are doing that for you. Avoid ad fatigue by rotating out ad variations. It's absolutely beautiful. All right. And so it does that. For paid online search, the prompt breaks that down as well. So structure the paid online search strategy as follows. All right. And then we have other digital advertising. So here we develop other campaign objectives, programmatic display advertising, native advertising strategies, video advertising strategies, sponsored content and advertorials. Excuse me, advertorials. Not used to seeing that word. Affiliate and partnership advertising, retargeting and cross-device advertising, performance tracking, good stuff. We have organic social, so it's going to have all the different social medias. So what's our posting schedule, platform selection, engagement and community growth strategies, influencer and brand collaborations, cross-promotion and multi-channel. It's just, it covers everything. You have print advertising. So what is the publication selection and distribution strategy? our ad format and design strategy, targeting and placement strategy, and so on. So again, we have email and snail mail and influencer as well. And so what it does is after it generates each of these, it's going to take each section, it's going to upload it back into our marketing plan generator master spreadsheet in the marketing plan output tab, which is right here. It just puts it right into our spreadsheet for us, just like that. And then it will merge all of those together, all the items together. It aggregates it into one item to be able to then mark everything complete. And that should be over here with our input, and it marks it complete as done. So as you can see, this marketing plan generator workflow allows you to quickly develop your entire marketing plan without needing to spend days or weeks thinking up the exact strategy that you would have to use yourself, all with just a few ideas and a little bit of information put in. And this is just step three of our marketing plan generator system that will write your product benefits, create your comprehensive customer avatars, analyze your website and ad copy, and more. And you can find all of that for free inside my free school community with the link in the description below. And if you found this video helpful, please make sure to subscribe to the channel, like and share the video, because it really does help get this information out there to business owners, to solopreneurs, people who are hustling, who could use this for their businesses. And if you want additional n8n tutorials and how-to, as well as over 30 additional n8n workflows covering social media posting, our marketing plan generator system, executive assistants, data scrapers, and so much more, click the link in the description below to join my free school community where you can get all of that right now. As always, I'm Bradford Carlton. Let's automate your success together.